Good morning, students. Today let us discuss on the topic which is the last topic of your fourth chapter, History of Indian Arts. And so today's topic is Art, Applied Art and Professional Opportunities. Art and Professional Opportunities. It means how art can become a means of providing professional opportunities or job opportunities, or how art can be beneficial, profitable and useful to the art historian who studies history of arts. Art history is an independent branch of knowledge. Art history, which means study about the arts, the origin of arts and development of arts. And so the knowledge of art history can provide opportunities of research related to arts, research related to arts. And so art history provides opportunities of research. Okay, the first one, art historian can work in the field of journalism. How are art and journalism related? So art historian, which means a historian who studies arts in depth. So how he can have opportunity to work as a journalist? Journalism is related to providing information. And so a journalist can have opportunity to work as a reporter, sub-editor, proofreader, designer, etc. And so a journalist who knows the history of arts can provide accurate information. He can provide accurate information about arts. And so an historian who studies arts can work as a journalist. The second one, art market is an independent field. What is the art market? Art market is a place where various objects of art are brought and sold. Artistic objects are brought to the market and are sold. And so these objects or articles might belong to various times, which means it might be ancient time, middle age, or a later period or a modern period. So these articles are brought and sold in the art market. It calls for a special expertise to assess the exact value of an art object or to ensure that it is genuine. Now who can assess, who can evaluate that an object which is brought to the market is having exact value and it is a genuine? So only an expertise who studies the history of art can evaluate and assess the exact value or the price of the object and also that it is a genuine object. So an expert with deep understanding of art history is required for this task. So an expertise or a historian who has knowledge about arts can help in assessing the value and genuineness of the articles or objects brought to the market. Third one, heritage management and cultural tourism are recently developed fields. Heritage management, which means managing and preserving the heritage, either it may be cultural heritage or a historical heritage. So whatever history related heritage are managed and are preserved. And cultural tourism. Tourism means visiting places for to get information, or either it is for a entertainment. So cultural tourism means visiting places, various places, to understand and study about a particular culture of a region. So these two fields are recently developed ones. And so in these two fields also there is a need for a historian who studies the arts. So in these fields, students of art can find many professional opportunities. Now who students or experts who have knowledge of arts or who study arts will have a various professional opportunities. Like how can they work or where can they work? They can work in museums, in archives, libraries, science and information technologies, archaeological research, Indology. So these are the some of the important fields where a art historian or students who study arts or history of arts can work. The next one, applied art. Let us understand what is applied art. The visual and performing arts are primarily looked upon as the means of entertainment for people. We studied that there are two types of arts, visual arts and performing arts. And these arts have become mainly for entertainment purpose. People look upon it for as just for entertainment. Suppose you watch a dance, you watch a drama, it is for entertainment. So the artist performs primarily with this purpose. So an artist who performs their art is doing with this purpose of entertaining people. However, there is a scope to combine an artistic creation with utility value. But it's not just for entertainment. There is a scope to combine artistic creation with utility value. What is artistic creation? Artistic creation means creating something that is of art. Suppose you compose a song, it becomes artistic creation of composing a song. You paint a picture, it becomes an artistic creation of painting a picture. So now how can you combine artistic creation with utility value? The picture that you have painted, if you sell it in the market, then it has got utility value. Now when you sell the painted picture in the market, it brings you money and so it becomes economically viable. And so this is called applied art. Combining artistic creation with utility value to bring in or to make it economically viable. So thus an artistic creation with a utilitarian purpose is called applied art. And now let us see what are some of these fields wherein these artistic creations are become or can become economically viable. So some of them are here: industry and advertisement. Industry and advertisement are related to art. So when advertisements are created, one needs to think creatively and artistically. Interior designs and production of ornamental objects. What is interior design? Interior design is a designing and decorating houses or interiors. And so this is an artistic creation or artistic work. Production of ornamental objects. Ornamental objects are things that are worn to decorate oneself. And so these ornaments, we see various types of ornaments creatively and artistically designed. Art design and stage backdrops. Art design and stage backdrops. What are stage backdrops? Stage backdrops are the backdrops or the designs that you put behind the stage or on the stage to give more impact to what is happening on the stage. So this is one of the artistic work. Art direction for films and television. So a director who directs for films and televisions also needs to have a creative thinking and artistic thinking. So it is related to art. Creating attractive layouts of books, magazines, calligraphy, production of greeting cards, invitation cards, customized stationery, gifts, objects, etc. are the fields of applied arts. So all these fields, in all these fields, one needs to have a creative thinking and artistic thinking. Next one, the field of architecture, photography are also part of applied arts. The field of architecture. architecture is a designing of buildings. So the architect who designs buildings should have a artistic thinking and also creativity. Photography is also one of the important thing where one needs to have a artistic thinking and creativity. So nowadays still and animated graphics created with the help of computers are used for various purposes. Now you see, we have a still and animated graphics created with the help of computers are used for various purposes, especially for films. So in films you see there are still and animated graphics are created in computers and are used for films. So this is one of the important artistic creation where an artist, you need an artist who thinks creatively and who can prepare graphics. This is also applied art. Ornaments, artistic creation of metals, earthen pots with colorful designs, objects made from cane and bamboo, beautiful glass objects, attractive textiles and clothing, etc. all can be listed under applied arts. So all these can be listed under applied arts because creating all these needs creativity and artistic thinking. Every field mentioned above requires a detailed planning and meticulous management of at every stage of production. What are stage of production? Before you get a final product or finished product, there are various stages of production it must have gone through. Like example, textile and clothing. Before you get a finished cloth, it must have gone through various stages of production, and so it is important to have planning and meticulous management at every stage of production. So for this you need to employ or keep trained and skilled individuals at every stage. And some of the production processes of artistic objects have a history of certain traditions. So producing some of the artistic objects, there is a tradition, certain tradition. Maybe because these artistic objects are historically made in a traditional community. The development of each productive process has its own history. So developing each stage of production has its own history. Hence, the syllabi of training courses of art design include the history of various industrial and cultural traditions. Now there are various training courses of art design, and so these training courses must include history of various industrial and cultural traditions. So there are few institutions in India which offer technical and occupational training in the above mentioned fields. Among them, National Institute of Design in Ahmedabad, Gujarat is a world-renowned institute. So this is a world-renowned institute. This institute has introduced an online course since 2015. So this institution provides online courses from 2015 about art design.